We can hear you.
My name is Cristina Robas. I work in the Planetary and Habitability Department at the Astrobiology Center in Madrid, Spain. There, I'm doing my PhD on regional evidences of hydrological cycle on Mars under the supervision of Alberto Fairen, Olga Prieto, and Ivan López. And I would like to introduce our preliminary geomorphological map, which is a first step of my PhD. Next slide, please. Our goal is characterizing the Sinus Sabaeus region to understand the role of water in the modification of its surface. We map a square-shaped area located in the southern equatorial region of Mars in the highlands at the southwest of Schiaparelli crater. This study area sits in a heavily cratered region suggested to extensive surface erosion, but still shows diverse signs of water on its surface. The topography is defined by two large valleys flowing from south to north. Between those valleys, there is a saddle, and there are two large eroded impact craters found to the northeast and southeast. Next slide, please. This is the layout of our geomorphological map. The base map is composed by CTX images. We also use TIMIS infrared images and topographical derived from MOLA HRSC. We draw and compile this 1,500,000 scale preliminary geomorphological map using ArcGIS. We define two different units. Most of surface is covered by intercrater planes unit, letter L, in orange color. There are some areas of the map identified as eroded terrain unit, letter D, light pink, which appear especially eroded. And we differentiate three channel-related units, blue is color, as the watershed unit, letter A, formed by two principal valleys. Runoff wall unit, letter C, which are walls with high channel density, and watershed 2, letter B, which is an intermediate step between the two previous units. The related units are fresh crater, letter H, in green, inverted crater, letter I, also green, and different ejecta morphologies in teal, as pancake, letter J, and multilobe, letter K. And inside the two big impact craters, we find two interesting units, of which I'm going to talk in the next slide. So please, next slide. Here, we saw two reticular units next to each other. The first one, that we call rich bedrock terrain unit, is characterized by numerous ridges in a polygonal pattern. The second one, that we call modified rich bedrock terrain unit, is in the middle of the image, surrounded by the rich bedrock terrain unit that is consistent with a large chaotic assemblage of small hills. This modified rich bedrock terrain unit is deeply eroded, and its limits are very well defined. So we think that its origin could be related with the action of some fluid. These two morphologies happen together inside both impact craters, suggest they could share the same origin. We are currently evaluating the possible formation mechanisms, but we are open to suggestions. Next slide, please. And in conclusion, our map contributes to the geological understanding of the region, and that is part of my PhD thesis. It provides an unprecedented description of the study area, which has only been partially studied before in works as Craddock et al., 1997, or Forsbeck-Taylor et al., 2004. Here we provide hydrological context that hasn't been studied in detail before, verifying the existence of past water activity. And that's all. Thank you very much for your attention.